see me yards. What's up with that?
I don't know. I guess I just – the ball just didn't find me at receiver today. I mean, I can't – we won, so a win trumps everything. I'm just glad Coach Brown had the confidence in me to let me throw that pass today.
Did you get ragged for it, holding up a little bit and having Trey have to adjust on it a little bit? Or?
No, because I mean, I get the two guys came. It's two guys that came, and I just got out of the way. And they told me that if something like that happens, to, you know, throw the ball away. But I was like, no. I'm gonna throw it up. I feel like Trey's gonna go get it. And sure enough, he adjusted, made a great play.
Did the wind hurt your ball a little bit?
No, I don't think so.
Should Silvers watch out?
Silvers. I'm coming at you now. I'm at that spot.
3 for 3 now, 2 touchdowns in your career. That's,
yeah. I mean, that's pretty good. I got to go back to Coach Brown and Coach Williams having faith in me to let me run plays like that. Because it takes you have to have a lot of trust in a player to let them run that play. So it feels good knowing they trust me.
That's part of a big play is, you know, any drive y'all scored on in the first half, it seemed like it was, you know, 1-2 plays.
Right.
What's been the leading up in practice into being able to execute that? Because y'all have been stringing together long drives most of the year.
It's just us becoming confident in what we're doing and actually just clicking as an offense. As you said, the last 2 weeks we just really clicked, scoring really fast, having a lot of explosive plays. It's just us doing finally becoming the offense that we knew we could be in fall camp and just becoming, just gelling right now.
Boy, eligibility. Again, for this team, how big is that for the program now, back-to-back years?
Say that again?
Is that bowl eligibility for this team? How big is it for the program now in back-to-back years?
It's big. You know, we at the start of the year, that's one of the goals you set is to be able to play at least play in a bowl game, let alone win it. So bowl eligibility is pretty big for us. We're still chasing after the conference championship, but bowl eligibility is really, very, very, very good for this program.
Go from the get-go, I think your first play was 13, 14-yard run. Second run for you was a 32-yard touchdown. How prepared were you for today's matchup with Chun being out?
I was pretty prepared. I feel like I had a great week of preparation coming into this game. And so I just really trusted my reads, taking what the defense gives me.
Something against those Georgia squads?
Yeah, man. I'm from Georgia, so I hold a special place for those schools in my heart, I guess you would say.
It's called on your trophy mantle, isn't it?
I guess you could say that.
How do you try to take advantage with Chun being out now, you stepping up into that starting role?
Say that again?
So how have you kind of tried to take advantage with Chun being out, moving into that starting role?
My whole thought process behind it is really just like, I don't want the offense to lose a step while he's gone. And so just putting extra emphasis on everything, my preparation, just very, very detailed in everything I do as far as run steps, looking at the defense, taking what they're giving me, and just a lot of minor stuff. Because like, you know, Jordan gone, not being able to play the past 2 games, I feel like, you know, it was time for me to step up and keep the offense above water as far as rushing the ball.
How have y'all been able to hit some of these big plays? Your first 3 drives were 2 plays or 1 play. How were you able to hit some of these big plays?
We knew the zone was going to be good for us going into this game. And so just through that, just trusting our reads, trusting our run reads, Crum, that's our read on the zone. So just trusting him, trusting that he'll get his block, and we'll take it from there.
How nice would it have been to get a 100-yard game, 4-yard shot?
Oh, man. I mean, it would have been nice. But, I mean, the ultimate goal really is to get the win. And so that's what we got. Honestly, I could probably care a little less about the rushing yards. But, I mean, I guess that's what comes with it.
What does it say about this backfield, knowing that, you know, one guy goes down, teams still have to worry about a 1-2 punch every week?
Yeah. You're going to have to repeat that.
So what's it say about this backfield that, you know, if one guy goes down, Jordan was out today, teams still have to worry about a 1-2 punch every week?
Yeah, I mean, that just shows you we have a strong backfield. Me, Jordan, Jamarius, BJ, we're all good backs. And we all, and I know Coach Brown trusts us all. And so really just having that 1-2 punch, I guess it is deadly for any team.
This offense is really seeming to be clicking right now with Jordan being out. He kind of holding that over his head that he's not there, but the offense is, seems to be working a little better.
Really, it's not. I'm not really saying nothing to him, like, far as that. Really just encouraging him, just like, hey, man, like, really just trying to help him get back as soon as possible and him be a factor as he's always been.
How would you rate John Johnson's pass?
How would I rate it? You know, I couldn't really tell because I was blocking on that play. I was trying to keep him from getting hit. So, I guess it was good since it was a touchdown. That's my assumption.
You going to give John a cold shoulder now?
Nah, he actually said something to me before we went down before the half. He's like, hey, you got more passing yards than you right now. So, try to stop that real quick before you got a big head on me. Nah, it's all fun and games.
Well, it was kind of an easy David office for you a little bit, but the way the running game was going.
Yeah, I think we had 8 plays at 1 point for 3 touchdowns. So it was pretty simple, handing the ball off, letting the O-linemen get some good blocks for the running backs, and you know, they ran really well today.
How have y'all been able to work up to getting some of these big plays? I know you had the 49-yard touchdown last week and then 3 big ones today.
Just you know, working hard at practice. I think we've actually had a lot of fun these last 2 weeks. Not worried about anything else going on around us. Just you know, focusing on football, and we've had a really you know fun time with each other, and I think that's what's paid off for us.
The beginning of the week, you talked about you guys hadn't beaten Georgia Southern. Coach talked about none of the coaches when he asked raised their hands when he asked if you guys beat Georgia Southern. How big was this win against this program?
Oh, it's big. You know, I was 0-3 before today. You know, spanked us my freshman and sophomore year, and you know took away a conference championship from us last year. So. You know, it was important coming in here and beating those guys, no matter their record, no matter who the head coach is, no matter what. Just beating those guys, you know, coming in here and beating them like we did, it's pretty good for our program.
You threw 18 passes today. You got a few more in you still?
Yeah, I feel like I'll be ready to go. I think I'll be ready to go. I don't need treatment this week, so I'll be ready to go.
Besides the long touchdown pass to him, you've made quite the connection with Trey for the last couple of weeks. What have you seen out of his progression?
Trey's just a hard worker. He's in there every day working hard. I think he got banged up first at that touchdown. I think he got banged up his knee, but you know he's really fast. He's really fast. He can really run deep, and it's something we didn't have last year with Ish getting hurt early in the season. But just him being in there, let spread the field out, and let him run. It's been good.
Did he get banged up because it wasn't you throwing to him? It was John.
I guess so. We'll put that on John.
How would you rate the pass, by the way?
Honestly, you know that play is. That can come back to me, too. So I was like, he looked like he was in trouble. I was over there, me and Crum and a few other guys. I was like waving at him. Then he threw it, and I looked down, and I was like, he caught it. I was glad it was a touchdown.
Josh, 96 yards rushing. How nice is that?
It's been big. You know, like I said last week, you know, having those carries in fall camp when Chum was hurt also really helped him. And, you know, it's not surprising to any of us for him going out there and rushing hard and breaking some tackles in a long run.
Well, how did it feel to get those last 3 years off your mind with that performance out there today?
Really, the last 3 weren't even in my head. Last year, just sitting so close to winning the conference championship and everybody on the defense, all the seniors, that's like been motivating us all week and quite frankly just pissed us off. So we were ready to get that W and win, and I think we did it. We started out a little slow at first, kind of being unsure with it. New coaching change. We knew they were going to run the triple option, but we weren't sure if like how they were going to do it, what wrinkles they were throwing in. So we kind of started off a little slow, but we found our bearings and then got a hold of things. So
haven't had a couple of years against them. Had that kind of prepared this defense for, or with so many new guys on this defense, it was kind of a learning curve.
Definitely having like quite a few older guys and playing against them every year, it definitely helps you. Helps us like teach the younger guys to be more disciplined to play that, because playing a triple option team, that's basically all it is discipline and doing your job. It can get really boring, you know, doing the same thing over and over again or not really making a play, but you are affecting the play and technically making it, even though you just cause them to pitch the ball. So.
How about Keelan Chairs? What did you see from him out there today?
He's like a little spark of energy out there today. He was having fun flying around, making plays, and you know, when Sam went out, he stepped in and is just like, you know, Sam was in there. He was making calls, helping us out. You know, there's a lot of times, you know, we're getting, like, signals and stuff in there late, and that's just them trying to get personnel groupings in and stuff to us. And he was helping us out a lot on the D-line, making calls. And we kind of caught on to him early about some of their trigger words of, like, you know, directions where they were going and stuff. And every time, you know, they would say it, he would echo it out all the way through the line. That way, you know, we didn't have to echo it. So it helped out a lot.
They had the ball for a long period of time, but then it seems like as soon as the offense got the ball, they were scoring. You guys were back out there. Was it kind of difficult to adjust to move as soon as offense scored? You got to go right back out there?
I mean, it always helps, you know, when the offense does stay on the field longer. But when they score, like, your energy level, the momentum's on your side. So it's just basically the same for us. We're full of energy. And, I mean, it wasn't hot today. It was cold, but, like, our bodies were fresh. Everybody was feeling good. So I think, I mean, it kind of does wear you down in the end, but like in the moment while it's happening, you're not tired, especially because you know the offense just puts so much life into you.
All three times, did you get over and barely get set down up the score? You got to go back out?
Well, sometimes you get over there and you have to turn around and get right back out. Most of the time, I was getting blood wiped off of me or something. But, you know, that's why I got, you know, Antoine behind me and stuff. You know, he's a great player, so, you know, we swap in and out. We stay fresh most of the time. It's very rarely that one of us starts and goes on the field and comes off and goes right back on. Usually we're constantly rotating to keep fresh legs in.
How would you rate John Johnson's pass?
You know, that play I thought was going to be busted for a second. And then, you know, under pressure, throwing a pass like that, that pass was pretty spot on the money. I know he played quarterback some in high school, so it definitely helped us out quite a bit. You know, offense jumping on them early like that, just it blows life into the whole game, the whole team for us. And it helps us stay motivated, even though they scored on the first drive. We're like, oh, hey, our offense is playing. They're playing the hearts out for us. We got to do the same.
Brandon, better watch out.
Yeah. I think John should go back there sometime.